Hello everyone, here is the last session on uterine fibroid. That is, earlier we talked about the body fibroids, today we'll talk about cervical fibroid. But before we go into detail of the cervical fibroid, I would like to pay your attention. Yesterday I uploaded a video on third session of uterine fibroid, where I explained you the clinical features. In the clinical feature, somewhere I said that the site of the fibroid is more important than the size. And I gave you the example of the small submucous fibroid and a big subserous fibroid. Right? By mistake, I explained you submucous fibroid as subserous one and subserous one as the submucous. So please correct it. It was actually by mistake. Sorry. So now going into detail of the cervical fibroid. These kind of fibroids form about 1-2% of all uterine fibroids. Location of cervical fibroid. They are at the portio vaginalis. Myoma projects into vagina and becomes polypoidal. That is at the portio vaginalis. It may be seen at the supravaginal cervix, were located at different parts of the supravaginal cervix, like anterior, so pushes bladder up. When located posterior, obliterates the pouch of Douglas and preys the rectum. When situated laterally, they are in the broad ligament and ureter is pushed laterally, but it lies below the tumor. Sometimes may be located centrally, so cervix expands on all sides when the myoma or when the fibroid is on the central part. So these are all the locations. Now the clinical features. We see first symptoms. No menstrual disorders present. What you will find more commonly is the pressure symptoms. These pressure symptoms include frequency, retention on urine, defecation on straining and constipation. Now we come to the signs. On perabdominal examination, the uterus and the appendages are felt separate. They are being situated on the top of the firm fixed pelvic mass. On pervaginal examination, cervix is felt expanded to form a tumor. It fills up the pelvic cavity or a mass is felt which is fixed with the cervix, which is pushed high up behind symphysis pubis, that is on pervaginal examination. Then we come to investigations, urine analysis and urine culture for infection, intravenous pyelography, renal function test. These are the important investigations in case of cervical fibroid. And then we come to the last part, treatment. Small supravaginal cervical fibroids don't produce symptoms usually. So treatment is not needed for such type of fibroid. Because symptoms are not there, treatment is not needed. Large supravaginal fibroids causing pressure symptoms are surgically removed. So the treatment is surgical, where the fibroids are surgically excised, surgically removed. And the surgical treatment is needed for the large supravaginal fibroids. So that was all about fibroid, that is cervical fibroid. With this, I have completed the entire topic on uterine fibroid. I hope you all have understood this topic very well. Thank you.